Today we're going to talk about strategies you can use to get into Kaiser Permanente Bernard J. Tyson School of Medicine. Kaiser Permanente's Bernard J. Tyson School of Medicine is located in Pasadena, California, and just welcomed its inaugural class of 50 students in the summer of 2020. Unlike most medical schools, Kaiser is not run through a university, but rather through a leading healthcare system that specializes in patient-centered care and population health. Though the medical school is new, Kaiser Permanente has been running residency programs since the 1930s, and students can take advantage of 6 clinical locations across Southern California. Kaiser focuses on integrated patient care and admits 48 students per class. In addition to its unconventional origins, Kaiser is blazing a new path for med schools in 2 major ways. One, it has a hands-on approach to its coursework in which students can begin working with patients in the first few weeks of school, rather than waiting till the later years to do so. Two, it is offering free tuition to its first 5 classes in the entering classes of 2020 through 2024. As is the case with any new medical school, applicants often have lots of questions about what it takes to get in. What are they looking for? How can I convince the ADCOMs that I will be a perfect fit? We'll talk about all of this and more in this video. I'm Michael Najem, Medical School Admissions Expert at Shemasian Academic Consulting. In this video, we'll discuss the unique aspects of Kaiser's curriculum, their free tuition policy, what they look for in applicants, and what you can do to maximize your chances of getting admitted. Let's get started. First, let's talk about the programs on offer at Kaiser. Kaiser Medical School is a 4-year program that offers a Doctor of Medicine degree, or MD. They also offer several other programs with other universities in Southern California. If you're interested in a PhD with the California Institute of Technology, or Caltech, you can apply to that program while applying to Kaiser's. In your second or third year at Kaiser, you can also apply to the Master's of Healthcare Systems Engineering at Loyola Marymount University, or the Master of Public Health at the University of California, Los Angeles, or the Master of Health Administration at the University of Southern California. With its hands-on integrated clerkships, you'll get to join a clinical care team in the first few weeks of your first year. You'll get to follow patients from diagnosis to follow-up and treatment under the guidance of various healthcare professionals. Not only do you get real-world experience from the start, but you also get access to their excellent student support system through coaching on well-being and resilience. Kaiser joins the ranks of schools like NYU and Columbia that are rethinking the financial burden that medical schools place on future doctors. The first 5 classes at Kaiser will have free tuition for all 4 years of the program. Kaiser values equity, inclusion, and diversity, so offering free tuition limits the financial burden on students for whom otherwise med school might not have been a reality. While the free tuition makes it possible for students to pursue lower-paying primary care specialties, it's worth noting that the school doesn't give preference to those students expressing interest in these fields. All students, including those interested in competitive specialties like surgery, dermatology, or anesthesiology, are encouraged to apply. Tuition is $54,719, though this will be covered for the first 5 cohorts. Healthcare costs will also be covered. Living expenses are estimated to be about $34,500 annually. Room and board will not be covered in the tuition waiver. Kaiser estimates that the average room and board cost, including utilities, would be about $2,000 per month in the surrounding area. They do not offer housing, but they do have a housing coordinator to help facilitate finding housing. Students are also required to pay a $100 student registration fee. Kaiser does provide need-based financial aid and will continue to provide financial aid even after the free tuition offer lifts for the entering class of 2025. Kaiser's admissions process is holistic, meaning that they consider the applicant's context while evaluating the applicant's academic and extracurricular profile. 36% of the inaugural class belongs to a group traditionally underrepresented in medicine, and 26% are considered non-traditional students. Now, let's take a look at the admission statistics. Kaiser's first class had a median GPA of 3.85 and a median MCAT score of 515. This means that in order to be a competitive applicant, you'll need to score highly on the MCAT and have high grades. Kaiser recommends, but doesn't require, organic chemistry and biochemistry. calculus, statistics, a population health, epidemiology, or other public health course, and knowledge of a language other than English. The important thing is that your transcript reflects a variety of courses across different subjects. They also want you to see that you challenged yourself and that you'll be able to handle the rigor of the courses at Kaiser. If you didn't take all of the required courses, have been out of school for a while, or have a lower MCAT or GPA, Kaiser recommends that you attend a post-baccalaureate program. You'll also need strong letters of recommendation. Finally, before applying to Kaiser, you definitely want to show that you have experience and interest in the healthcare field through shadowing physicians, pursuing health-related extracurriculars or service opportunities, and conducting research. Your Kaiser secondary essay is a unique opportunity to demonstrate why you would be a great fit for their program. Kaiser Medical School has three secondary essays requiring a response of 250 words max. Before getting to the specific prompts, we recommend taking time to read about their mission and values so you can get a clearer idea of what qualities they're looking for in an applicant. Remember, secondary prompts occasionally change from year to year for any school, but what remains constant is ADCOMs are looking for students whose qualities align with the school's value. Kaiser's vision statement is, "Our graduates will be a diverse community of compassionate healers, lifelong learners, and courageous leaders of change within the profession and in society. They will have the skills, capabilities, and resilience to lead the transformation of healthcare delivery in the nation and a lifelong commitment to the highest values of the profession." Their website emphasizes that Kaiser is a great fit for future leaders of the medical field, the visionaries, the advocates, and the mission-driven, as well as those interested in rethinking our healthcare systems and how we care for our patients. Kaiser notes that a passion for learning paired with a collaborative spirit will help our students excel in an educational environment focused on excellence, well-being, and teamwork. Because Kaiser is so focused on how the environment and social factors affect patient care, consider listing any experiences you have that demonstrate an interest in population health or the social factors that affect a patient's well-being. You can also list your best qualities and most formative experiences. See if any themes emerge between them that you could string into a compelling narrative that showcases what you care about, who you are, and what brought you to medicine. Now, let's jump into the essay prompts. Prompt 1. During your career as a physician, you will potentially encounter many obstacles and be required to overcome many challenges. Resilience is a prerequisite for success in medical school and beyond. Describe your experience with a situation that had an unfavorable outcome. How did you react, and how might you have responded differently? What did you learn about yourself? Here, the admissions committee is trying to gauge your ability to deal with the difficult challenges that might arise in your time at Kaiser and in the medical field at large by asking you to reflect on how you have overcome challenges in the past. Their use of unfavorable outcome prevents you from choosing an experience that worked out fine in the end and means that they are really focusing on what processes you've developed to cope with difficult situations. They want to see that you were able to gain perspective, even if the end result was less than ideal. Make sure when responding to this prompt that the experience you choose isn't one that focuses on your negligence or failure, but emphasizes your ability to maintain a positive mindset and learn from setbacks. For example, you might talk about volunteering at a community garden and learning through the illness of a new friend that some treatments, like a plant-based diet, have to be pursued early or they might not have enough of an impact. You can find an example of this essay in the description below. Prompt 2. Kaiser Permanente is nationally recognized for its achievements in the realm of equity, inclusion, and diversity. How will you contribute to the diversity of Kaiser Permanente School of Medicine? Because equity, inclusion, and diversity are at the core of what Kaiser does, they want to make sure that their student body reflects that. This diversity prompt is less about essentializing your identity and more about highlighting elements of your background and experience that might contribute to a rich student body and learning environment. Think about what elements of your background, perspective, or experience are unique and build a narrative from there. Question 3. Lifelong learning is an essential process for continued professional development in physicians that includes reflection and being open and responsive to constructive feedback. Tell us about an area of intellectual exploration you are passionate about and have sustained over time. What means have you used to explore this area? This question is your chance to let your passion come through for your potential specialty. You can discuss your motivations and how you've gone about pursuing your area of interest. Try to connect it to healthcare, if possible. Use this essay as an opportunity to showcase that you're not intellectualizing your field of interest, but that you really care about it on a heart level. Getting an interview at Kaiser is a big deal. It means that they really liked what they saw on paper and want to get to know you more. Kaiser does a combination of the MMI, or multiple mini interviews, and one-on-one interviews. MMIs are structured to understand how you think through a situation by giving you hypothetical scenarios. Never fear, MMIs do not test for knowledge of content. They will not ask you to diagnose from a set of symptoms. Many students get anxious about the MMI because you cannot prepare responses to prompts in the same way that you can for traditional interviews. But there are frameworks you can use to think through any scenario thrown at you. Check out our MMI guide in the description below to learn more. As you prepare for interview day, make sure you know your application inside and out. Be prepared to talk in more depth about the area of interest you spoke about in your essays. You really want your interview to build on the information you wrote about in your essays. Also, take care to research Kaiser's programs and offerings prior to the interview. Don't be afraid to reach out to current students on LinkedIn or search med student boards to see if you can find insight into what the interviews were like. In the interview itself, prepare thoughtful questions about the school and make sure to engage with your interviewer as well, asking them questions about their field of interest. Remember, your delivery matters just as much as the content of your responses. Be sure to get in plenty of practice so that you can come across as relaxed, attentive, and sociable. This way, you'll convince interviewers that you're just the type of person they'd want to study alongside in medical school. That's it. We've shared strategies to help you stand out when applying to Kaiser Medical School so you can maximize your chances of getting accepted. If you found this video helpful and would like to see more like it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos. And to learn more strategies to get into top medical schools like Kaiser, download our free guide in the description below, How to Get into Medical School. The guide contains all of the same strategies our team uses to help students get into top schools like Harvard, Johns Hopkins, and NYU. All right, thanks for watching. See you next time.